Now his hat comes off. The buzzer. You see the ball rolling right into the cap? There it is, out of the glove. Right there.
The sun will come out tomorrow. Bet your bottom dollar that tomorrow there'll be sun. Just thinking about tomorrow clears away the cobweb and the sorrow till they're done. When I'm stuck with a day that's gray and lonely, I just stick out my chin and grin and say, oh, the sun will come out tomorrow, so you gotta hang on to tomorrow. Come what may, tomorrow, tomorrow, I love you, tomorrow, you're always a day away.
That's a fly ball.
The Chicago Cubs, Summer of 79, is brought to you courtesy of the Coca-Cola Bottling Company of Chicago.
Abe Kingman won the Major League home run title with 48. Bruce Sutter captured the Cy Young Award, and the team made noise like a contender until late August. That in capsule form was the story of the 1979 Cubs. They finished fifth, their record 80-82. The classic game was a 23-22 marathon with the Phillies in May. It was bombs away from the start.
Batting average 270. Look out, there's a high fly, left field, that's still going back. Back she goes, back. And it is on the catwalk, it's a home run.
Later in the first inning, Bob Boone faced Dennis Lamp with two on.
That's hit. That's way back there. Back she goes. Wow, another home run. Three more runs in for the Phillies.
Pitcher Randy Lurch put the Phillies ahead 7-0 against Donnie Moore.
Fly ball, left center. That's pretty well hit. Wow, come on. A home run for the pitcher.
Bill Buckner began the Cubs' comeback in the first inning.
There's a base hit. And a run comes in. That one just made it.
Dave Kingman then narrowed the gap with two men on.
That's it. Way back there. Stay there, baby. Back. Hooray! A wave of amateur homer for Dave Kingman.
Ted Sizemore cut the deficit to 7-5.
There's a drive left field, and that's going to bring in a run. Here comes Jerry Martin as Ted Sizemore laces a good shot to left center field.
Donnie Moore capped the first inning rally.
There's a drive right center field. That's going to be all the way to the center field wall out there. And what Ted Sizemore score on this run is Donnie Moore decides to go for third. His ball is slow. He is safe. Wait a minute. The ball is against the dugout fence.
The Phillies scored five runs and led 12-6 when Gary Maddox batted in the third.
There's a high fly to left. That's pretty deep back there. That's going back. The wind's got it. Back she goes. Home run. Oh, boy. The 17-mile-an-hour wind did it for Maddox.
Pete Rose made it 16-6 in the fourth inning.
And there's a drive to right center field. That's going to be another double for him. Maybe three this time. Here comes Bowler robbing third, and he goes into the plate easily.
Maddox made it 17-6 moments later.
Got a homer and a double in the same inning. And he's going to get himself another double right here, maybe three. There he goes. One run in, Pete Rose scores.
In the Cubs' fourth, Kingman batted with a man on.
That's well hit, way back. Say goodbye, back. Kingman, two runs into the top. Almost the same spot as the other one. Almost landed on the roof of that building across the street on Waveland Avenue. Boyd did he belt that one.
Woo!
Steve Ontiveros was the next Cub hitter.
That's pretty well hit. Way back there. Back, back, back. Hey, hey! A home run for Ontiveros. Number one of the year for Steve.
So the Phillies led 17-9 when Larry Boa batted in the fifth inning.
The pitch popped up. It could be trouble. Over Buckner's head, the wind carries it in play. It drops. In front of Bale, bounces away from him, goes to the wall. Espinosa will score as he comes around.
Pete Rose was the next batter.
Swing ground ball to his left of the shortstop. Jesus Bobelson picks it up. Ken drops it again.
The Phillies led 21-9 when DeJesus batted with the bases full in the Cub fifth.
He tried to curve him, and he loses it. How about that?
Bill Buckner brought the Cubs four runs closer in the fifth.
Oh, there's one hit deep to right field. Hey, hey, kiss it goodbye. A grand slammer by Buckner. And four more runs are in.
Jerry Martin brought the Cubs two runs closer.
High fly ball deep to center field. It's going. It's going. And you can kiss it goodbye. Jerry Martin with a two-run home run. His third of the season.
In the sixth, it was 21-18 Phillies when Dave Kingman batted with the bases empty.
Hey, kiss it goodbye. It is gone. Oh, I thought he hit the other one hard. That one's in Milwaukee. It hit the front porch of the third house across Waveland Avenue. Man, oh man, isn't that something? That is unreal. Kingman's third home run of the ball game.
The Phillies had a 22-19 lead when Bill Buckner started a rally in the eighth.
There's a well hit ball, center field, dropping in, base hit. And the Cubs have a run as DeJesus comes across and Thompson stops at second.
Jerry Martin kept it going.
There's a ground ball up the middle, a base hit. Here comes a run in. Okay, Thompson's in, and the tying run is in scoring position.
Barry Foote then got a big hit.
There's a ground ball bouncing in the left field. Come on, Steve. Come on, Ottawa. He's going to score. It's a tie game. Oh, brother. Woo, boy. Look at that score.
The tie lasted only until Bruce Sutter faced Schmidt in the 10th inning.
Here we go. Shakeoff may have been a thing. There's a high fly to left. Look out now. Look out. It's gone. It's a home run by Schmidt. Oh, brother. Mike Schmidt has just gotten his second home run of the day. And now the Phillies lead in this ball game by a score of 23-22. The 3-2 pitch, he was ready. Sutter laid it in there and pow. Out of the ballpark, over the left center field wall.
From that point on, Sutter produced a season of split-fingered magic. He collected 37 saves to tie the National League record. His ERA was 2.23. He became the Cubs' second Cy Young winner ever, joining Fergie Jenkins, who won it in 71. Sutter again was the winning pitcher for the National League All-Stars.
Don't go changing to try and please me. Never let me down before. Don't imagine you're too familiar, and I don't see you anymore. I would not leave you in times of trouble. We never could have come. I took the good times, I'll take the bad times, I'll take you just the way you are.
Mr. Green, Yeah.
You need any help?
Mm-mm.
Want my Coke?
No.
Really, you can have it.
Okay. Thanks.
That's the way it should be. I like to see
you around
the whole world smiling with me.
Coca-Cola. Hey,
fly ball deep to right center. Well hit. The wind has it. Carrying it back. They leap. Holy
Matthew. Oh.
He caught the ball. What a catch by Matthews. No, I can't believe that. He leaped high, made a backhanded catch. Here is the greatest catch that I've ever seen. Watch this. Leap. There he goes. 36. Freezes. Has the ball in his glove. What a tremendous catch, getting a standing ovation.
For manager Herman Frakes and his Cubs, it was a season of peaks and valleys. Amidst the fun and excitement, attendance boomed. The Cubs drew 1,648,000, their third largest home turnout ever. A home road total, a team record of 3,346,000. Here's what they saw.
Very high pop foul. Has Buckner got a play? Close to the dugout. Ooh, he wanted it. Did he or didn't he? He caught it. How about that? Boy, there's the catch of the year up till now. Watch this catch. Look at that. Wow. There's a bat handle pop-up. It's foul. Buckner running hard. He's got it. The ball game is over. Oh, what a finish. Bill Buckner with two sensational grabs in 2 days. There's a drive to the left field. Wait a minute, no play. Tries by Castro. The Cubs have won the ball game.
What a tremendous catch and a game-saving catch for Holtzman. There's Martin moving quickly to his left. And at the last moment, timing beautifully, the ball, and he dives for that ball and comes up with it. Hits the glove about a foot above the ground to make a tremendous catch.
Ground ball up the middle. And a stop by DeJesus. Over to Sizemore for one with a bare hand grab. Relay. And gets his man for the really flashiest double play we've seen in a while. Let's look at this one again. Unser forced. Boone doubled up. Now watch DeJesus take a base hit away from him. That's number one. Bare hand grab by Sizemore. Wasn't even close before it was over, although it bounced into Buckner.
Line drive, well hit, could be way back. Up, 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 it's gone. Kiss it goodbye. A grand slammer for foot. What a beautiful line drive into the corner, scoring four runs. He's taking his time. He's going to love it all the way around the bases. Kingman scores. Hunter-Barra scores. Martin scores. And so does Barry Foote. Fourth home run of the season for Foote. And four runs in. That's what I meant when I said the Cubs could put it away right here. Ground ball. It's a diving stop by Kelleher. The throw to first. Beautiful play. And this ball game is all over. Boy, what a play by Kelleher. He really robbed Stargell. No runs, no hits, no errors, nobody left. Final score. The Cubs 5, the Pirates nothing. Well, here we go with the retaliation. Now, Mike Krukow hit, of course, Barry Madoff when Jerry was at bat. Now he has to stand on the batter's box, and Saucier let him have it. There we go. Krukow and Saucier after each other. Woo, boy. So the bench is empty. A smash back to Russell, looking for the double play, and he got it. Spectacular plays I've ever seen. Oh. There's a safe hit. And Kingman stops at second. Wait a minute. The ball gets away from Bowles. He's going to score. He's going to score. It's all over. There's a drive in the left. He did it. He did it. The ball game is all tied up, and the winning run is in scoring position. And how about this ball club? There's a ground ball between first and second. It's a base hit. Here comes Henderson.
Come on,
here's the throw by Griffey.
They did it again.
Steve Ontiveros has done it again. Oh, man. Dale swings, lines that ball down the left field line. Fair ball. Going to the corner. Ontiveros round second. He's going to try to score. Here he comes around third. Here comes Vale into third. The throw is too late.
There's a well-hit ball deep to right center. Way back goes this one. It is caught, and there's a collision out there as Martin and Thompson collide, and the ball is jarred out of his glove, and Blake McBride will go all the way.
Let's see if he gives him the dipsy-do. Or whether he reaches back for something after the fire went by him. Here we go. Fastball. Ground ball. DeJesus gobbles it up. Here's the throw. The ball game is all over. And the Cubs have won a beauty. Kenny Holtzman with his 31st career shutout. A super performance. Fly ball. Left center field. This game's over. There's the catch by Delaney. And that takes care of it. One run. One hit, no errors, nobody left. Final score, Cubs 8, Houston 3 as the Cubs sweep the doubleheader. There's a base hit in the short left field. Now Robinson has the ball, Joe says keep coming, the throw is high, he is out. You gotta wave him in, you have no choice, this is the winning run, you gotta keep him coming. Good work by Ott of a high throw.
There's a pretty well hit ball back to right field. That's pretty well hit back there. Hey, hey!
A home run for Bittner. Hey, hey! Larry Bittner, put it out of here. Oh, talk about a happy guy. Look at this.
Dive. Side-armed him beautifully. There's a drive, right center field. It is
caught. A diving, unbelievable catch by Thompson. Hangs onto the ball. jars himself, makes the third out, and that's one of the more spectacular catches of the year.
Fly ball, left field. Kingman going back, still going back, and he makes the leaping, reaching grab on this one.
Swing and a fly ball in the right center, hit deep. Martin going after it, still going after it. Reaches out and makes a one-handed catch. Watch this grab. Reaching out as far as he could, right on the end of the glove.
There's a line drive left center of base hit for Buckner. And here comes Scott Thompson in the mouth. The title says, keep coming. Let's take the lead in this game. And the Cubs are out in front.
The Cubs, you know how I feel about you. And the WGN, they know how I feel. And I don't want to get maudlin up here about that, so I won't. But I know this much. I know that any time we've ever had things like this, I've sat up there in that booth, and I've watched very wonderful ceremonies down here on the field. But it always seemed to me that it wouldn't hurt to do what I'm going to do now. And that is, instead of always facing this way, well, they're marvelous. But out there behind me in those bleachers, I see the greatest fans in the world. So with your permission, I would like to turn around and give a low bow to maybe three generations of the greatest fans who ever lived.
Dave Kingman drove in 115 runs to go with his 48 home runs in 79. The Kong batted 288, compared to a lifetime average of 232. His awesome power caused people to stop and stare.
Stop and stare, they don't bother me, for there's nowhere else on earth that I would rather be. Let the time go by, I won't care if I can be here on the street where you
smile.